Smith has got those tapes, and she's going to use them if I don't do as she says.
You're not going to let her get away with that, are you? You're a match for Smith.
Vera, we're in trouble if she uses those tapes. And if I'm living with you and it comes out, well, you'll be hauled into it as well.
What are you saying?
I'm moving out.
Why?
Vera, if I'm going down, I'm not dragging you down with me.
That's ridiculous.
Oh, let's face it, love. I'm nothing but trouble to you. I mean, why give Smith a double satisfaction?
I don't care about Smith. I care about you. I don't want to lose you. I'm not going to give you up just for this. We'll fight it, both of us. Please, Terry.
Vera, I'm finished. She's got me. Who knows how many copies of that tape she's got, or who's got them?
I'm not going to let Smith ruin our relationship.
Vera, I know what your career means to you. I have to go.
Terry.
Is that this morning's Age, Julie? I haven't had a chance to read it yet.
It's the last time I'll be signing this thing.
What are you talking about?
Smith and those bloody tapes.
And to me, something else has happened.
Yeah, I suppose I should have told you the whole story in the first place.
Yeah, well, come on. What happened?
There's no reason why you shouldn't know now. I spoke to Smith. She's got a copy of the tape.
She wants something for it, right?
Oh, when she's good and ready, yeah.
And if you don't play ball, it'll end up on the governor's desk.
You guessed it.
Then if you do her a favour and she promises to give you back the tape, you can bet she'll have made a copy of it.
The old blackmail game.
Yeah, when it comes to getting blood out of a stone, Smith's an expert.
That's why I'm getting out. As long as she's got that tape, I won't be able to sleep at night.
8 years service down the drain, eh?
Can't say I wasn't warned.
Yeah, well, I'm going to miss you, mate. Bloke doesn't make many friends in a place like this.
My resignation will be on the governor's desk first thing in the morning.
I wish there was some other way.
Oh, we'll have a beer now and again.
Yeah, sure we will. Listen, I better get back to it.
Yeah, sure. Well, I'll see you later.
Yes, sir, Terry. Vera, what's the matter?
Nothing.
Well, it doesn't sound like it. Come on, what's wrong?
I've just got something in my eye. This sore, that's all.
This wouldn't have anything to do with Terry, would it?
No, why should it?
Well, if the women see you like that, they'll just take advantage of you.
Yes, sir. I suppose you're right.
So at least rest in here until you can cope. Okay?
Jim, I've got some urgent business. Do you suppose I could have the afternoon off, please?
Yes, of course. I think we can cover for you.
Thank you. Really appreciate it.
Vera. Good luck, eh?
Thanks.
Would you check that number for me, please, Julie? I'm sure there's someone home, but there's no answer. Perhaps there's something wrong with the line. Oh, you're leaving us early, Miss Bennet.
Oh, yes, Mrs. Davidson, but it's all right. I've spoken to Mr. Fletcher.
Well, you don't look very well.
I'm just feeling a little off colour, that's all. Nothing serious.
Are you sure? Is there anything you'd like to talk about? Sometimes it helps to get your problems out into the open, even if they're personal.
Oh, no, Mrs. Davidson, I'll see how I'm feeling in the morning.
All right, good night.
Hi, Bea. Do you reckon Dave will let Lizzie come back yet? I'm really starting to miss her.
Well, I don't know. Anything's possible, but do you think she really wants to come back?
Well, she's without all her mates, isn't she? It must be awful for her.
What, in maternity, with all those babies around her?
Do you reckon she's missing us?
I don't think she's given us a second thought, Doreen. She got babies to hug and rattles to rattle. Now, you understand that, don't you?
Yeah, of course I do.
Yeah, if anyone goes gaga over babies, it's you.
Yeah, I know. Still miss her, though.
Yeah, I know, like we all do. Oh, come on, ladies, let's shut up shop.
Right, that's it for today, ladies. When you get cleaned up, go to the recreation room. All except you, Smith. I want a word with you.
Oh, but I'd hate to miss the evening news, Mr. Fletcher.
Why don't you have someone tape it for you first?
Oh, whatever do you mean?
Gaffney's blackmail tape. Hand it over.
I don't know what you're on about. Didn't Terry tell you I gave it back to him?
Come on, don't play dumb with me, Smith. I know you had it copied first.
Oh, I was just kidding. Got to make life in here interesting somehow.
I want that tape, Smith.
Well, I'd love to give it to you, Mr. Fletcher, if it existed.
Terry's a decent sort of bloke, you know. He's honest and he's straight.
Yeah, with someone who's paid to lock people up, I suppose he's not a bad bloke.
When someone blackmails him like this, we all suffer, you as well as us.
Oh, how's that?
Well, all sorts of people work in prison, Smith, as we both well know. You get your bad apples like...
Like
Jock Stewart. Mm. That's right. But when someone gets blackmailed like Terry is, the system has a habit of turning up a real louse to take his place. I'm sure you've seen it happen before.
Well, I'll tell you what I'll do, Mr. Fletcher. If I hear of anybody giving Terry a hard time, I'll let you know.
Hello? Dr. Vaughan, yes, put him through, please, Julie. Oh, hello, Doctor. I'm glad you called. I've been trying to... What? Good heavens.
She'd been telling me how ill she was, and I never really believed her. Now she's collapsed. A nurse found her by the phone.
Well, do you know what the trouble is?
Erica, I'm sorry. I can't talk to you. I'm calling from the hospital. I'd like you to come here as soon as you possibly can. They're going to operate right away. Your mother has a cerebral thrombosis.
Boy, what a way to go. What are you doing, hon?
Jim let me off early. I said I was feeling sick.
Yeah, you're not making it any easier. In fact, you're making it harder for both of us.
Look, Terry, you don't have to go. Please don't go.
I do have to go. If Smith gives that tape to the governor, all hell's going to break loose. I mean, Jim will be dragged into it, you'll be dragged into it. Look, we went through this in the staff room.
Terry, there's more to this than Wentworth. Please listen to me. You think that my job at the prison means everything to me, don't you?
It's a large part of your life, yes.
I thought so too. But that was before you came along. Surely you realize that. Look, a long time ago, I fell in love with a man who turned out to be a criminal.
You're kidding. Boy, you can really pick him, can't you?
Even after I knew all that, it didn't stop me loving him. Oh, Terry, please listen to me. I was ready to throw away my career, everything, just to be with him.
That's not going to happen this time.
I haven't let myself feel that way about anyone until now. Even if they sack you or drag your name through the mud, I'll stand by you, I promise.
I really mean that much to you?
Of course you do. Without you, there's nothing.
Yeah, well, you're not so bad yourself now I think of it. Mind you, I don't like to think about it.
Oh, Terry, please don't resign. Let's see if we can find a way.
Oh, I don't know. While Smith's got that tape, there's not much I can do about it. Besides, I promised Jim I'd have my resignation on the governor's desk tomorrow.
Let's try one more time. I hate the idea of Smith forcing you out.
Yeah, but I'm not too ramped on it either.
Let's fight back.
What, and get you the sack? No, look, I'll think about it, right? But you stay out of it.
On one condition.
What's that?
That you take the clothes out of the suitcase and stay.
Ah. Blackmail. I can't win, can I? No matter which way I turn, I'm blackmailed.
It's not blackmail. I'm just doing it for your own good.